There are wide range of factors that affect a child's nutrition and optimal development. It is not possible to achieve the nutritional targets until these factors are understood. Household food choices, cooperation between the parents, how well the responsibilities are shared within a household, mother's happiness and knowledge, and effective provision of early intellectual stimuli are some of these underlying factors. A collective effort of people and the health workers is necessary to change these factors in the community for the better. Health promotion is the strategy adopted by Plan Sri Lanka to work with children, communities and the public health midwives to collectively identify and address these factors to improve healthy growth, optimal development and well-being of the children.
Since the weight of our children was low, we got together and started to provide meals as groups. We started with 3 or 4 children in a group. Now there are 7. Mothers collectively prepare and give food. Earlier weight either increased or decreased only by about 50 grams a month. Now it has changed. Weight increases by 300 to 400 grams. It's easy for us too. We don't have to force feed the children. When they are together, they eat freely and happily. At the same time, we feed them for their 5 senses to stimulate their brain development. The main reason for me to bring health promotion process to the village was when I came to know some of the problems they faced. When I started there, there were 8 underweight children. Now it has come down to 2. Mothers with a high body mass index level were able to reduce 2. We were able to change the food purchasing habits, that is, reducing buying foods with high level of fats and sugar.
The fathers and mothers of the village now say that even though there is only 1 mouth to feed the body, there are 5 mouths to feed the brain.
This is a model baby room. This was designed by the mothers of children under 5 years. We constructed this so that the other mothers can learn to design a similar room at their house. Many people in the village have done so. Mothers help each other in groups to build this. Now the interaction and harmony between them is more. The social activities of the children too have improved. After we started this process, we provided our children with opportunities to get together and play. We were able to get positive results. They know each other very well now. They exchange their toys. When they meet on the way even, they readily talk to each other. This process enhanced the cooperation, brotherhood, and the harmony of our village. So we will continue this.
අපි දැක්ක මේ ප්‍රවේශයෙන් ප්‍රජාව බලකරණය වෙනවා. එතම කියනනම් මේ
We saw that this approach empowered the community and they were motivated. They took ownership of the efforts to address their health problem. Being overweight and obese has turned out to be a problem even among our rural communities.
After we started monitoring the body mass index, most of the mothers started to reduce weight by 500 grams, 1 or 2 kilos a month and so on. They are so enthusiastic about their own health. If they were unable to come for the regular weighing at the clinic, they come to my house and get it done as soon as they could. Those days we had large quantities of rice on a large plate like this. Now it's only 2 spoonfuls in a much shallower plate. We consume more vegetables and green leaves. I have already reduced my weight by 10 kilos. About 20 families in this village reduced the consumption of chili, milk powder, biscuits and fatty food. Their health improved. We keep records of these.
Happy Calendar is a novel concept developed by the Rajaratna University of Sri Lanka with the participation of several communities. It is a method to monitor the moods of the family members during the day. This method identifies how much each other's delight, distress, and anger affect the other family members.
Most of the days I was sad, angry, or unhappy. The calendar helped me to reduce those. Pradeep says so too. Even though his work is tiring, he now comes home cheerfully, he says. Some mothers say the happy calendar is a miracle that changes family life. Our principal marks the happy calendar of our staff. There were a lot of gloomy faces at the beginning. All faces are now happy because no one wanted to get marked as unhappy. So the teachers come to school cheerfully. Even the children have their happy calendars. Not only that, they have taken the message home and marked the happy calendars of their parents.
School children are taking the lead in spreading health across the community.
We discuss the risk of being overweight with parents who are found to be overweight. We discuss with them about reducing sugary and fatty food. Those who drank 6 to 7 cups of tea a day with sugar have cut down to 2 or 3. We discuss how one can enjoy a long life by reducing sugar and fatty food stuff. They were very happy to realize the amount of money that they can save in addition to the health benefits gained by these practices.
More days, hours and seconds we spend happily, the more we enjoy our lives to the fullest. This was a story of such people who understood this and got together to collectively make each other's lives happier. For them, the life is not over yet. It has only just begun.